the smartest film critic in the world, Cole Smithy.
Hi, this is Cole Smithy and your guide to classic cinema. Far From Heaven is Todd Haynes' virtuosic homage to the cinema of Douglas Sirk, famous for All That Heaven Allows, 1955, and Imitation of Life, 1959. The movie is a politicized melodrama brimming with detailed social commentary. Haynes' dynamic range of socially informed filmic storytelling is exquisite. The context-rich narrative observes upper-class mannerisms, private and public, native to the Eastern Seaboard circa 1957. In Hartford, Connecticut, children call their moms mothers. Ladies, lunch. Men work in lavishly modern wood-paneled offices of companies with names like Magnatech. The upper class views itself as middle class. Dennis Quaid displays a wonderfully understated reading as corporate family man Frank Whitaker. A closet homosexual, Frank engages in after-work trysts with other men. Frank's doting wife, Kathy, played by Julianne Moore, is a perfectly coiffed vision of 50s-era motherly and wifely perfection. Arrested for loitering in a movie theater, Frank's secret life starts to become apparent. Later, a spur-of-the-moment evening visit by Kathy to Frank's corporate office to deliver a homemade dinner results in a shocking discovery. Regular visits to a psychiatrist promise to break Frank of his sexual addiction to other men. Meanwhile, Kathy plays out her part as one of Hartford's leading socialites. Her stylish, well-kept home and her kindness toward Negroes becomes public record via a local magazine featuring the camera-friendly Kathy Whitaker. Haynes' perceptive scrutiny of an idyllic 50s-era right-wing American dream fabricates a corollary between racism and anti-gay views, as well as between Hartford's wealthy white suburbs and its black ghettos. The Whitakers have a black maid, played by Viola Davis, whose token status is lessened somewhat by the home's mild gardener, Raymond Deegan, played by Dennis Haysbert. A mutual attraction between Kathy and Raymond leads to an afternoon spent visiting a black restaurant in Raymond's neighborhood. Witnessed together by one of the ladies who lunch, rumors about Kathy spread through her social circles like a virus. While Frank gets time off with a paid vacation for the family due to his crisis of personality, Kathy is forced to side with the racist status quo of her community. Even Kathy's self-proclaimed best friend, Elle, played by Patricia Clarkson, shows her unreliable colors when Kathy speaks longingly of Raymond. Douglas Sirk's striking palette of saturated primary colors propagates every frame of Haynes' perpetually autumnal setting. The contrast of gritty dramatic material against an idealized, fascistic social atmosphere makes for an enthralling movie experience. Kathy, Frank, and Raymond are socially repressed characters yearning for an earthly human connection different from what society deems acceptable. The romantic dramatic tapestry that Haynes crafts is as informative as the romantic tragedy is devastating. Far From Heaven is a masterpiece of LGBT cinema.
Happy New Year, darling.
That it adheres to a classic cinematic model designed by one of the 20th century's most visionary directors allows for a special variety of transcendence for its audience. Heaven is not what it pretends. Thanks for watching, and visit colesmithy.com for more.
Thank you.